The last year has brought a heightened focus on cybersecurity, and for good reason. We've entered almost a new era of international relations. We're seeing more actors, more threats, more sophistication, more victims. At Microsoft, we've been increasing our cybersecurity investments, but one of the things we've learned along the way is that part of the country's cybersecurity challenge is actually a cybersecurity workforce challenge. We don't have enough people to do the jobs that need to be done. Today, I'm at Whatcom Community College in the beautiful city of Bellingham, north of Seattle in the state of Washington. It's one of the national leaders in cybersecurity education. Across the country, we need to turn to the nation's community colleges. We need to work with them and support them to educate a bigger, broader, and more diverse cybersecurity workforce. There's no better way to learn than to talk to the people who are leading Whatcom, studying here, teaching here. Let's see what we can learn from them. And here we are today. Whatcom Community College has this amazing national resource called Insight. Mm-hmm. What does Insight stand for, and what is it?
So Insight stands for the National Cybersecurity Training and Education Center. The goal is to increase the cybersecurity workforce throughout the nation by assisting colleges and universities to graduate more students that can go into the field. There are over 500,000 job openings right now that cannot be filled. By not filling those jobs, basically, we're making the country more vulnerable to attack. So it really is a matter of national security.
It's become a crisis in the workforce. And so one of the things that we feel that we really need to do is to partner and to collaborate with government, private business and industry, other higher education institutions, as well as the K-12, because it's about creating a pipeline of students. Students who first become aware of the possibilities of a career in cyber education or cybersecurity, and then gradually getting the needed skills and meeting the competencies so that they are employable and they are meeting the workforce needs within their communities or throughout the nation.
I've had an interest for a long time in community security. So that was one reason I chose cybersecurity as a future field, is because I wanted to kind of combine something that involved learning a lot more technical emergency response in a way. So this is kind of a different version of emergency response.
Believe me, you are going to be joining a profession that is, as we like to say, the first responders, the digital first responders. So I think you absolutely hit the nail on the head.
I would say the best argument for coming to Whatcom is just watch the news for 5 minutes. There's a new cybersecurity incident almost daily now, and there's dire need for professionals that can handle it. And Whatcom's a great place to grow those professionals.
It doesn't matter what kind of job in the cybersecurity sector you take, because the issue is that there's so much demand and there's very little supply. This field changes rapidly and you'll never be bored. And you'll never have to worry about a job.
We are funded through a huge grant by the National Science Foundation. And it is those government entities, along with others, the White House included, that have provided us the support to continually look at expanding our programs. And in order for us to expand, we need government assistance and assistance from private business and industry to be able to hire faculty at the going rate and to be able to recruit and retain students. So it really is a collaboration. It's a partnership that we're seeking.